Everyone, this is the Nerdy Plane. Welcome to another tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to fly a sailplane in Flight Simulator 2004. So that's like taking off and everything, because it's really hard to, because it doesn't have an engine, so it's actually really hard to get it off the ground. But when you actually know how to, it is actually easy. So as you can see here, I'm just at the main menu for Flight Simulator. So on the select aircraft, you're going to want to click on change. And you can choose any of your planes there. I'm just gonna use the default sailplane that Flight Sim comes with. It's the Schweizer 232 sailplane, which has the yellow with a red trim. So click on OK. I've already got it set to Culture Shore Lady. I've got the rest of that set, so I'm just gonna click on Fly now, and I'll pause it and then unpause when it's ready. Actually, no, it looks like it's taking quite a quick time. Okay, yeah. Alright, so as you can see, we're down here. Now, it has no engine, so that's pretty much no way to get go anywhere. But in order to get up in the air, firstly what I'm going to do is you're going to want to click on Alt and Enter so that it toggles full screens. But if you're already out of full screen, then that's alright, because then you'll have all of that. Once you're not in full screen, then you can then maximise it so that it's like this. Then you're going to want to head over to... I'm just going to pause it now because this happens straight away. But you're going to want to click on World, go down to Map. Then you can zoom in a little while. So I'll zoom into about there. Now, the reason why I paused is because when you click on OK, it goes straight away. And if you haven't paused it, then I'll just be flying straight away. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to be heading that way, kind of. So I'm going to want to change the... heading by 180 degrees, so then it will actually be 220, and then hit on enter. That's why I paused it, because if I hadn't paused it, then it would have carried on going. So now that I'm looking that way, I'm going to set my altitude here to plus and then 2000. So that will bring me into the air on the map. Now, the reason why I'm in the map and not in the flight analysis is because when you have a look, when you hover over it, it says read only in flight analysis, and it says that for all of them. But anyway, once that's at plus 2000, that's all right to be flying. And then I'm also going to set airspeed to 150. So now that it's like that, when I click on OK, I'm now up in the air, and as you can see, my airspeed is actually on 160. But anyway, you're up in the air, so now you can fly your plane. Now, I'm just going to take the brakes off by pressing on dot. It didn't seem to work. Anyway, unpause. Press on B to set my altimeter correctly. And brakes are off as well. So anyway, that's me now flying the sailplane. You can do everything. That's the possibly easiest way to get it up in the air. There might be other ways, but I don't know them. This is the only way that I do it. Now, there are also a few add-on planes that you can find around. Add-on sailplanes, they should work exactly the same. And for what I just did then doesn't work the same for the sailplanes. You can do that for any type of plane. For example, if you're just flying like a Boeing around, you could set the altitude to 20,000 and once it's on 20,000, set the airspeed up. It's just a quick way to get going into the air, really. So anyway, thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed it. I hope it's been useful for you, because I only worked this out today, which is why I've only just done it, because I knew how to do this for quite a long time, but I never thought that I could use it to get a sailplane up in the air. But anyway, here I am now, flying this sailplane around. So I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to like, please, and if you have any comments for like recommendations of videos I should do next, or any questions, then you can put them down in the comments section. And also, please don't forget to subscribe. So for now, thank you for watching.